गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आवर क्लास इज सोशल साइंस एंड वी विल सॉल्व यूनिट नंबर 9, द अर्थ आवर हैबिटेट, वर्कबुक पेज नंबर 50, क्वेश्चन नंबर 24। व्हाट इज द रोटेशन डेली मोशन ऑफ द अर्थ कॉल्ड? द अर्थ रोटेट्स ऑन इट्स एक्सिस फ्रॉम वेस्ट टू ईस्ट डायरेक्शन। This circular motion of the earth is called rotation or daily motion of the earth. 25. What is the revolution annual motion of the earth called? The earth completes one full circle around the sun in 365 days and 6 hours. This motion, annual motion, is called revolution. 26. What do you mean by an orbit? The earth moves in space in a specific imaginary path or route around the sun. This route or path of the earth is called orbit. 27. How many seasons are there on the earth? Which are they? There are two seasons on the earth. They are summer and winter. 28. What is Dakshinayan? From June 22nd, the direct rays or means light of the sun shift means move from Tropic of Cancer towards the south of equator. It is called Dakshinayan. 29. How many constellations are in the sky? Name the famous constellations. There are 27 constellations in the sky or space. Some famous constellations are Ashwini, Revati, Vishakha, Purnavashu, Mrigashira, Rohini, Pushya, Adra, Swasti, etc. Question number 6. Explain the following terms. Latitude, the horizontal imaginary lines drawn on the earth's surface are called latitude. The total number of latitudes are 181. Number 2, longitude. The vertical imaginary lines drawn on the earth's surface are called longitude. The longitudes meet each other at the poles, north and south. These lines come closer to each other while going to poles. There are total 360 longitude. Among 0 degree and 180 degree longitude are important. Equator. An equator is an imaginary line around the middle of the earth. It is halfway between the north and the south pole at 0 degree longitude. It divides the earth into a northern hemisphere and a southern hemisphere. Question number 7, page number 51. Answer the following questions briefly. What would happen if the earth did not rotate on its axis? If the earth did not rotate on its axis, then all places on the earth would not face the sun alternately. As a result, day and night would not happen. There would be day constantly on the place which faced the sun. The place which did not face the sun would have night permanently. Number 2. What is meant by latitude and longitude? The horizontal imaginary lines drawn on the earth's surface are called latitude. The vertical imaginary lines drawn on the earth's surface are called longitude. Both imaginary lines are drawn on the globe of the earth. Question number 3, give information about the Greenwich Meridian. All question answers are written from textbook. So if you read textbook very carefully, you can find all these answers. The 0 degree longitude which passes through Greenwich City of England is called Greenwich Line. Greenwich Line divides into two equal parts from east to west, which is known as Eastern and Western Hemisphere. The longitude up to 180 degree east of Greenwich Line are called Eastern longitudes. up to 180 degree west of Greenwich lines are called western longitude. Question number 4. Give information about the international dateline. 180 degree longitude is called international dateline. It is just one longitude. The date and time changes when we cross this line. It is not exactly at 180 degree at same places. It is in zigzag form. If it is drawn straight, it will cross some islands or some countries, and two dates will mix up on the same islands or countries and create confusion. To prevent this confusion, the line is diverted and drawn through the sea, not on the land. What is meant by rotation? Like a top, the earth rotates on its imaginary axis from west to east direction. This circular motion of the earth is called rotation or daily motion. The earth completes a cycle of 1670 km per hour on equator. It takes 24 hours to complete this cycle one day. That means one day. Question number 6. What is meant by revolution? The earth moves around the sun as it rotates on its axis. It takes 365 days and 6 hours to complete this revolution, means 1 year. The earth rotates on its axis by making an angle of 23.5 degree on its axis and 66.5 degree along its orbit. Due to revolution of the earth, the season occur and day and night extended and shortened. Question number 8. There are 29 days once in every 4 years in February. Explain this statement. Since 1 year of Earth is 365 days and 6 hours, but it is difficult to calculate 1/4 of the day. 6 hours means 1/4 of the day. So we count year having 365 days. To compensate, remaining 6 hours are added to the month of February every 4 years. Example, February has 29 days in the place of 28 days. We call that year leap year, 29 days in February month. Question number 2. Why is the international deadline drawn zigzag? The international deadline passes over the Pacific Ocean. There are some islands in this ocean. Some parts of this island lies to the east of 180 degree longitude and some part to the west of 180 degree longitude. If international deadline is drawn straight, it will pass over the island area of some of these islands. So, island will have 2 days and two dates on the same day. This will create confusion. So the international deadline is diverted into the ocean, keeping the land area of the island on the side. That is why the international deadline is drawn zigzag. How are the day and night formed on the earth? The earth is round and only half of it gets sunlight and other half remain dark in opposite direction. It is the day on the area where the sunlight falls and night in the opposite area. The earth rotates on its axis, so different areas come opposite to the sun one after another. The area of the earth which is in the sunlight gradually goes into opposite direction of the sun. The area of the earth which is in the opposite direction, means dark direction of the sun, gradually comes into sunlight. This way day and night occurs. Question number 4. Why are days and nights longer and shorter? Or give geographical reason. Days and nights are longer and shorter. The Earth revolves around the Sun with the axis inclined at 23.5 degrees. So, the northern and southern hemispheres remains inclined to the Sun. Sun rays fall directly on Tropic of Cancer on 21st June and on Tropic of Capricorn on 22nd December. Where the sun rays fall directly and in the adjacent means nearby areas, the days are longer and nights are shorter. When the sun rays fall inclined diagonally, the days are short and nights are long, while days and nights are same length on 21st March and 23rd September. Question number 9, here you have to draw this eclipse, solar eclipse, explained by drawing the figure. Moon is close to Earth and sometime while revolving it comes between Sun and Earth. At this line, as the shadow of Moon constrict or restrict, Sun is not visible. This event is called solar eclipse, as the Moon is very small to the Sun and it cannot cover whole sun. The solar eclipse cannot be seen all over the world together. Solar eclipse occur on no moon day, but this event does not take place on every no moon day. Lunar eclipse, you have to draw this. If Moon gets light from the Sun, if the sun rays going towards Moon are obstructed by the Earth, then that part of the Moon remains dark. That part only Earth's shadow falls on Moon and not visible to us, which is called lunar eclipse. This event occur on full moon night, but not take place on every full moon night. This chapter is over. Now next period we will go for fourth chapter, social science. English we will cover next week after one social science class. Okay, so you write it in your workbook and send to me accordingly. See you. Thank you very much.